Hello friends, welcome back again. We are learning Kingdom Protista, and in this video we are going to talk about euglenoids. We have learned about dinoflagellates and chrysophytes. These are also similar organisms like dinoflagellates. They are also having two flagella, but not longitudinal and transverse like dinoflagellates, but the flagella is short and long. One flagella will be shorter and other will be longer in case of euglenoids. So that is the main difference between dinoflagellates and euglenoids. These are also aquatic organisms, that's why, but mainly freshwater organisms. We have seen that dinoflagellates are mostly marine organisms, but these are opposite to that. These are freshwater organisms found in stagnant water. Stagnant means steady, which is not flowing. So in steady water, these euglenoids are found. They have pellicle. What does it mean by pellicle? Pellicles mean the protein rich layer instead of cell wall. So cell wall will be absent in them, and instead of this cell wall, this protein rich layer means protein will be present in that layer. So protein rich layer is present, which is called pellicle. So this pellicle gives them flexibility. Okay, they have two flagella, as we have discussed earlier. They are photosynthetic in presence of sunlight. Okay, they can perform photosynthesis. Also they have photosynthetic pigments and perform photosynthesis in presence of sunlight. But the main feature of these organisms is that in the absence of sunlight, they are heterotrophics. They predate on other animals, they kill other animals and feed upon them, and they can be heterotrophics in absence of sunlights. So that is the main characteristics of these euglenoids, which can be called as connecting link between animals and plants. Why? Because they contain photosynthetic pigments like higher plants, so that's why in the presence of sunlight they can perform photosynthesis, and in absence of sunlight they can be as animals. Okay, so that's why they are called as connecting link between animals and plants. This is the main characteristics of euglenoids. The example is euglena. You can see in the figure that they are eukaryotics, so that's why they are having nucleus and some granules and cell organelles, and contains two flagella, one is shorter and other is longer. So this